I've started playing Nier Reincarnation again, so I thought I'd show where my account is at. Let's click into it. So I started playing again after the first anniversary celebration, which was such a bad time to get back in because I missed all the free stuff, which is very sad, but oh well, that's life. And I've mainly been focusing on subjugations this time. I used to be a bit of a PvP nerd, got into the top 50, but I don't know, I just don't like PvP as much as I like subjugations this time, so that's mainly what I'm trying to focus on. So in order to sort of progress with subjugations, I'm kind of going for a few, trying harder to go for some of the Dark Memory characters. Anyway, let's get in and have a look at the characters I have first, and I've been very lucky since coming back. I'll just sort by levels. So A2, not level. Yeah, okay, we'll go levels. So I've got a fair few to 90 now. So I've got these three, my main three, which is Celebratory Gale, 2P, and A2. They're all at 90 now. And they all absolutely carry my account. Excuse me. And then a couple of handout units like this Fio and Argo are also at 90, but they both kind of suck. Fio's sometimes good for subjugation, but yeah, that's kind of that. I finally got my first EX character, which is Gale. I was going for her for PvP, but also her sword is just like so good for subjugation. I've got the healer F66X like last time. I got this fractured bald man, very good. I just ascended him once to unlock his skill, which is fatal, I think. Yeah, just for the extra crit damage. That's a pretty good buff to crit damage, but it's only for 60 seconds. Okay, who else is good that I have? Oh, I got this. I had one copium pull on the current banner for the Bloody Lavania, and I got him. So that was very, very lucky. I've ascended him once because of his Void Rush, which is very, very nice. So it's at 22% currently. Just for my dark subjugations, I think there was a triple S clear which used him, so I wanted him since dark is my best. Or was my best subjugation. Very good character here with the Abstract Gale for PvP. Although she'll probably be replaced with the old EX Gale. Who else is handy on this account? Oh yeah, Firefighter Griff. Lacrima Griff, really good for PvP and for subjugation. I might take him to the next level. Not sure what his next skill. Oh, it's Blaze Rush. Probably will ascend him eventually. I'm trying to save books for EX Lavania when I unlock him. I got the Fire Lavania with the Blaze Rush. Who else is handy? Oh yes, Fractured Lars. Very, very good for subjugation because he has a defense break skill. Which is very nice. Okay. That's probably it for my sort of higher tier characters. Oh, no, I've got two more. I got Fractured Deimos, which is really, really good. Or Deimos, however you say it. It's really good for the wind subjugation because he has this Imperil ability where he increases wind damage received. So it's like a defense break for wind. The Argo, the new Argo, has that for water, so I really want him as well. And then I got one of the best PvE characters with bloody F66X, and she's good because she has the highest heal in the game with 50%, so you don't get it all in one chunk, but you get 10% over the next 5 turns, which is huge. So they're my main characters at the moment. In terms of weapons, I have the two Dark Memory weapons as my two strongest, so I've been working on Lavania's Fist, got 3 more stages to go, need the Zeniths, so I can get EX Lavania. And then I've fully upgraded Gale's Sword, which is great. Just need to work on a few of the skills. And then in terms of like great swords, let's go through each of the weapon types one by one. I'm pretty set for most of them. I think the only 4-star weapon I don't have is a water staff, because I missed all the free handouts. So in terms of short swords, I've fully upgraded the Blackhorn sword as well. These Blackhorn weapons are broken. Highly recommend upgrading them. A couple of good PvP ones with Sword of the Titan there, and Tormented Decolator. Still needs a few Black Pearls, but that's alright. I've been working on 2P's Light Sword for Subjugations because it has Lucid Boon. Great ability, and Ambush, another great ability. And then this thing, I think it's sort of Blade of the Lost Seal. This thing is broken as. It has a defense debuff for 30 seconds. That's basically a character skill in a weapon skill. And it recharges every 21 seconds, so you should be able to maintain the defense breaks if you time your attacks properly. And then there isn't too much else exciting in terms of my short swords. Just got this wind one from Fractured Lars, pretty good. And then I've been working on Lars's sword, not evolving it just yet, because I want to get Lavania ASAP to progress my account. Alright, that's the short swords. Let's have a look at the great swords. Nothing too exciting here, so Machine Axe, this is my strongest sword by a mile. Huge attack, look at that. 2700, damn. And then still using Virtuous Treaty. Another one I picked up the other day was this one with the Blaze Boon. This is a really good sword, Core Expelling Blade. The Blaze Boon's broken, like, look at that. 24% damage up. I think it goes up to 30 maybe? It's ridiculous. And then this is also a very good sword. High attack, really fast skill recoveries, 19 seconds and 15 seconds. Lots of people think that ability cooldown is only important for PvP, which is partially true. But it's also important in subjugation if you're going for a double knockdown with a character. Like a double character skill, sorry, during knockdown. Just helps to fill up the gauge quicker. A good 3-star weapon which I've upgraded is this Outlaw Hatchet, and that's because it has Blade Boon. Alright, let's look at a different subtype. We got guns. Nothing too exciting here. This thing is really good. I highly recommend getting your hands on this if possible, and if you get a second one, I would highly recommend not fusing it and keeping it separate. And the reason is it has this skill here. 60 second buff to attacks with 2 or more hits. It's ridiculous. Very strong. And then this thing too. This is Lacrima Griff, I think. This is his gun. And it's got Boon and Ambush, which are two of the best skills. Alright, that's it for the guns. Back to weapons. I'm pretty weak in terms of the other weapon types. So in terms of the staffs, excuse me. There's not too many good ones. Abstract Saryu's is one of the best. Once again, because it has a boon. And it also has a AoE defense break for 15 seconds, which is really good. And there's not too much else to see. This thing's good for PvE because it has a nice big party heal. And another good PvE staff, which is a 3-star, is this on here, the 3-wing staff, because it also has a party heal. Good against water. Alright, keep backing out of the weapons, my bad. Spears, I have a lot of really good spears. The best two attacking spears I have are the Type 3 Lance. Really quick recovery on the skills, and it's got a render, so a defense break. Very good. Plus two vigor abilities. In terms of like what abilities you want in a good subjugation weapon, you want ambush, an elemental boon, or either vigor or pursuit. Anything with that is just really, really good. Like this thing. This thing has boon and training, which is also another good one, which increases the number of normal attacks you do. Good for PvP as well, training. And then, sorry, the other good attacking spear I had was the Tormented Furrower with an attack buff and a blitz. Very nice. So then lastly, it's just the fists. So I have the Lavania fists, as I mentioned earlier. The Wicked Bottles, which are free handouts. I think you could have got a second copy of this during the Nier Automata collab or the first anniversary, can't remember. But this thing's really good because it has... if I just find it, there we go, it has Void Boon. So another boon and a vigor. Very good for subjugation, as well as having a defense break. And then these are the Bloodless, the Fire Lavania's Fists. Extremely, extremely high attack for a hatcher weapon. Like level 70 with about 2500 attack. Absolutely broken. and then the rest of the fists aren't too impressive. Lots of Dark Fists from all my copies of Lavania. I think I have every version of him except for EX. And then in terms of PvP stuff, these fists are what you want to go for. Really quick ability cooldowns, and it has Fleet Foot, which is what you're looking for. Okay, so that's basically my account. Just quickly look at the companions. I've done a lot of work on these for subjugations. So I have eight, roughly, at level 50, two getting really close. And then still a few that need work, but I'm hoping to get every single one of these to level 50 in at least 2 or 3 months' time. So I think I'm going to start making a few videos showing my subjugation clears. I've managed to work my way towards SS in all of them except for, I believe, water. I'm really struggling, like versus fire subjugation, I'm really struggling with that one. I just don't really have any strong water weapons apart from A2's machine axe. So I'm like struggling to get knockdowns in the first two waves. And I'm not willing to invest Zeniths into Argo and Noelle's weapons. So as you can see, strongest versus water at the moment, which isn't too common, but most people are better at light and dark, and then versus water is the easiest of the three elementals. And then I managed to somehow pull a really strong SS2 against wind. I think I got quite lucky in that run from memory, but I will go through a couple of my runs when I get there. Alright, so that's the state of my account at the moment, and I will post some subjugations soon. Catches.